This film is set in a family home in a nice American neighbourhood. This is strange because typically settings like this are usually included in comedy or drama films. The fact that it is set in an ordinary house gives the audience a feeling that it could happen to anyone. This emits fear into the audience because then they can worry whether or not they'll experience something similar. However, it is quite difficult to force people to feel that way. This family home seems completely fine, like any other everyday home. The filming is sometimes done in the two youngest children's bedroom, which is full of toys, a usual convention of a children's bedroom. The house is haunted because it's built upon an old graveyard. Only the headstones were removed in the process of building of the houses. This can worry people, as they may not know the area they live in properly, and many graveyards are built upon now that churches may close down. The Bowen family are the main characters in this film. The youngest child, Madison, played by Kennedy Clements, is around 3 or 4 years old. She is the only one of the family who can communicate with the poltergeist. Madison looks very innocent and vulnerable, so the producer has used this actress to make the audience feel fierce for such a young child. The middle child, Griffin, played by Kyle Catlett, is a very nervous child. Griffin is incredibly scared of clowns, so the poltergeist is using this against him. As he is the older brother of Madison, he is typically meant to protect her, but he is unable to. The eldest child, Kendra, played by Saxon Salbino, is a teenage girl. She is portrayed as a typical teenager, addicted to her phone. On the night when the parents go out, the only way the poltergeist captures Kendra's attention is by messing with her phone. The mother, Amy, played by Rosemary DeWitt, is a stereotypical mother. She stays at home, makes breakfast, lunch and dinner, etc. When Madison gets captured by the poltergeist, Amy is the only one who can communicate with her. This shows a very strong mother-daughter relationship. The father, Eric, played by Sam Rockwell, is a stereotypical father because he is working to provide for his family. When Madison gets taken, both parents suggest getting a specialist to figure out what is happening. This shows that they both care for their children. The songs TV Set by Spoon and Next Stop by Bleached are quite jumpy tunes. These songs can be in the action-filled scenes, however, not the scary scenes. I think this is because they seem to be too cheerful and jolly. However, the song Blast Him by Jay Chataway seems to be used at very tense, dark moments in the film, as it is just a continuous ring for around 30 seconds. The main theme of Poltergeist is a very dark, mysterious song. This is used at the beginning and ending credits. These songs are very different to songs included in comedy films, for example. The way the music makes you feel is very useful in films. A composer, Mark Stratenfield, creates very twitchy and tense orchestrated songs. This is good in a thriller film, as the tenseness of the music creates a tense feeling to the film. Stratenfield composed around 20 songs for the soundtrack of this movie. Many close-up shots are used effectively to show the fear in the characters' faces. For example, when Griffin is looking at the clown, you can see the terror in his facial expression very clearly. Another example of close-up shots is when the camera is zoomed in to the clown's face. This gives the audience an idea of the daunting look of what is haunting Griffin, allowing the viewers to feel the fear which the actor is experiencing. The producer has used many point of view shots and over the shoulder shots, which allows the audience to feel like they are in the film, so they can experience the terror in the movie. A long shot is used to show when Madison is holding her hands to the static TV screen. I think this is shown to give the audience an idea of how she communicates with the poltergeist, and also the fact that you can see her whole body in quite a zoomed in shot shows her vulnerability because of her height.